Good morning, students. This is class 10 science. Today we are going to study periodic classification of elements. So class, in the last session's class, we have studied about Mendeleev's periodic table, limitation of Mendeleev's classification, its significance and limitations of Mendeleev classification. Today we are going to study modern periodic table, the periodic table today. Or we can call it modern periodic table. So, what is modern periodic table? First of all, we'll know what is modern periodic table. Henry Moseley, an English physicist, did certain experiments and concluded that the atomic number is more fundamental property of an element than atomic mass. Till now, all the scientists were using atomic masses, but Moseley concluded that atomic number is more fundamental property of an element than atomic mass. He gave the new periodic law known as Moseley's periodic law or modern periodic law. What does this modern periodic law states? It states that physical and chemical properties of elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers. What does it state? Physical and chemical properties of element are the periodic function of their atomic number. Instead of atomic mass, he considered atomic numbers. That is, if the elements are arranged in the increasing atomic number. Previously, we were arranging elements in the increasing atomic masses, but Moseley arrange the elements in their increasing atomic number, and after a regular interval, elements with similar properties got repeated. And his table was known as modern periodic table, and the prediction of properties of elements were made with more precision when elements were arranged on the basis of their atomic number. And what happens once Moseley arranged the elements in the atomic, in the increasing atomic numbers, all the demerits, the anomalies of Mendeleev were solved automatically. All the demerits here, what we consider the anomalies, were automatically solved. Then we'll study about what are the characteristics of modern periodic table. First of all, it is based on atomic number. The table consists of, modern periodic table consists 18 vertical columns known as groups. It contains 18 vertical columns known as groups and 7 horizontal rows known as periods. Then see, the modern periodic table contain 18 vertical columns known as group. Group 1 elements are known as alkali metals. Group 2 elements are known as alkaline earth metals. Group 15 are known as pnoxygens. 16 are known as chalcogens, 17 are known as halogens, and 18 are known as noble gases. So we will concentrate our study till alkali metals, group 1, group 2 alkali earth metal, then 17 halogens and 18 noble gases. What are alkali metals? The elements in the first group, that is lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium, are called alkali metals. They were given the name because they all react with water to form alkalis. And the alkali metals are shiny, soft, highly reactive solids at standard temperature and pressure, and readily lose their outermost electron to form cations with charge +1 and have number of valence electrons 1. So they are termed as alkali earth metals. Alkali earth metals are lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. They all are known as alkali earth metals. Now, the elements in the second group, elements in the second group, that is beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, and radium, are called alkaline earth metals. They were given the name because their oxides are alkaline in nature. They all are shiny, silvery white, somewhat reactive, hard solids at standard temperature and pressure. They lose 2 electrons from the outermost shell to form cations and charge have a charge with positive 2. And the number of valence electrons is 2. Then comes the halogens, 7th group, the elements in the 17th group, that is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, they are termed as halogens and they exist as diatomic molecules. The symbol X is often used generally to refer any halogen. They were given the name halogen from the Greek words hal, which means salt, and gen means to produce, because they all produce a wide range of salts on reacting with metals. The halogens exist at room temperature in all three states of matter, that is solid, example iodine, liquid, bromine, gas, fluorine, chlorine, and the number of valence electrons is 7. That means they have 7 electrons in their outermost shell. Then the noble gases, the elements in the 18th group, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and the radioactive radon are called noble gases. They all are odorless, means they do not have any smell, colorless, they do not have any color, and monoatomic gases with very low chemical reactivity. Since their valence shell is considered to be full, they have very little tendency to participate in chemical reaction. And when discovered and identified, scientists thought that they are exceedingly rare as well as chemically inert, and therefore these gases were also given the name as rare gas or inert gas or noble gas. And they have 8 electrons in their outermost shell. Then, how did Moseley classify this, the modern periodic table? The modern periodic table is classified into metals, non-metals, and metalloids. Metals, non-metals, and metalloids. What are metals? Metals are electropositive as they form bond by losing electron. They are form bond by losing electron. Metals have 1, 2, and 3 electrons in the outermost shell, and they easily lose those electrons and form electropositive ions. In general cases, oxides of metals are basic in nature, and they form, metals forms basic oxides. Metals form basic oxides. Non-metals. Non-metals are electronegative as they form bonds by gaining electrons. Non-metals gain electron, therefore, thereby forming negative ion. And in general cases, oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. They form acidic oxides. Then metalloids, the elements which show the properties of both metals and non-metals are called metalloids or semi-metals. And they are boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, antimony, cerulean, and polonium. They are metalloids. What were the merits of the modern periodic table? See, first of all, Moseley's classification was based on atomic number, and atomic number is more fundamental property of an element than atomic mass. Fair. The anomalies which were the demerits which were present in the deficiencies which were present in Mendeleev periodic table got automatically resolved. Position of isotopes at one place is justified on the basis of the atomic number, because all the isotopes have same atomic number but different atomic mass, so they were all placed at the same position. Then the systematic grouping of elements has made the study of elements easier. Then position of elements which were not justified on the basis of the atomic mass, such as cobalt, nickel, it was automatically resolved, is now justified on the basis of the atomic number. And the whole table is easy to remember and reproduce in terms of electronic configuration and properties of elements. But modern periodic table has also one or two demerits, that hydrogen resembles both alkali and metals and halogens, but it is been placed with the alkali metals because its atomic number is 1. So hydrogen has been given the position in alkali metals. Then trends in modern periodic table. Now we will study the trends of modern periodic table. What are the trends of modern periodic table? First of all, variation in valency or valence electron. See, in a group, elements have the same number of valence electrons down the group. Number of shells increases. In a period, elements have the same number of shells, and along the period, valence shell increase by one. First of all, in a group, we'll study about group. In a group means members of the same group have same valency and have same number of valence electron. Same group members, suppose first group, first all the members of the first group will have same valency. All the members of the first group will have same valency and same number of valence electrons, such as lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. They all have one valence electron and their valency is one. Down the group, as we move down the group from lithium to sodium, sodium to potassium, potassium to rubidium, the number of shells increases. Down the group, shells increases, but valency remains the same. But in a period, what happens in a period? Number of shells remain same. Lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and neon. They all belong to the second period. So they all have two shells. Number of shells remain the same, but valence shell electron increases by one unit. But the valence in, electron increases by one unit. So first of all, we'll study about valency. Valency of an element can be calculated from the electronic configuration in two ways. There are two ways of calculating the valency. First is, if the number of valence electrons are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the valency will be 1, 2, 3 or 4. But if the number of valence electrons are 5, 6, 7 and 8, then valency is equal to 8 minus number of valence electrons. So an element which is having 5 electrons in the outermost shell, 8 minus 5, it will have 3 valency. 6 such as oxygen, 8 minus 6 will have 2. 7 such as chlorine, 8 minus 7, 1. So it will have 1 valency. Then neon, 8 minus 8, 0. So all the elements of a group have the same number of valence electron. Therefore, they all have the same valency. It's a very important point. First group elements will have one valency. Second group elements will have two valency. All the members of the 13 group will have three valency. 14 will have four, and so it continues. Means the group will represent the valency of the electron. Valency of the electron. Then variation in atomic size. Variation in atomic size. Now, atomic size, or also known as atomic radius, it is defined as the distance from the center O of the nucleus to the valence shell of the atom. It is atomic radius, can be defined as the distance from the center to the outermost shell. Center of the atomic nucleus and the outermost shell of an isolated atom. It is usually expressed in picometer, PM. Atomic sizes expressed in picometer, P-I-C-O-M-E-T-E-R, PM. And let us study the variation in atomic size along the period. First of all, along the period, we'll study along the period. Along the period, atomic radius decreases because means on moving from left to right across a period, or moving from left to right across a period, the atomic radius decreases. And why does this decreases? This is due to the increase in nuclear charge that tends to pull the electron closer to the nucleus and reduces the size of the atom. Let me see over here. I'll explain you with the help of a picture. See, this is the valency atomic size. See, on moving from left to right in a period, when we move from left to right in a period, the atomic size decreases because nuclear charge increases. For example, let us take the example of second period. Elements of the second period are lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine. The atomic size will decrease, means lithium will have the biggest size and fluorine will have the smallest size. Point to know that atomic size of noble gases in corresponding period is largest due to the presence of fully, this we need not to explain this. In a group, atomic size increases down the group because new shells are being added in spite of increase in nuclear charge. What happens? The atomic size decreases from left to right. Atomic size decreases when we move from left to right. And I've explained you why does this decreases. This is due to the increase in nuclear charge, which tends to pull the electrons closer to the nucleus and reduces the size of the atom. So lithium will be biggest and fluorine will be, size of fluorine will be smallest, because number of shells in a period are same, but valence electrons are increasing. So nuclear charge tends to pull the electrons closer. Followed, but when we move down a group, when we move down a group, atomic size increases. Down a group means when we move from lithium to sodium, then potassium, then rubidium, then this, we are moving from down the group in this manner. Atomic size will, what will happen to the atomic size? Atomic size will increase, and by this atomic size increases due to increase number of shells. Number of shells increases in every group, so the atomic size goes on increasing. Atomic size grows on and goes on increasing, so the metallic character will also increase, because what is metallic character? Metallic character is the tendency of an atom to lose electrons. What is metallic character? Metallic character is the tendency of an atom to lose electrons. In a period along the period from left to right, metallic character decreases, means when we move from lithium to fluorine, metallic character will decrease. Metallic character will decrease, but down the group, from lithium to francium, down the group, metallic character increases. In group, metallic character when moving from top to bottom increases because the atomic size and tendency to lose electrons increases. So we can say in a particular period, most metallic, most reactive, see in this periodic table, as we move down the group, metallic character increases, size increases. Size will increase because number of shells are increasing. And metallic character means the ability or the capacity to lose electron will increase. So the most reactive metal will be here and the least reactive will be here. And if we move in this manner, metallic character decreases. Metallic character decreases and non-metallic character increases across a period. And down a group, it metallic character increases. We'll continue in the next class. We'll continue. Thank you and have a nice day.